There's the hottest coach in America, Mark D'Antonio, really building this Cincinnati program, giving him a shot at a bowl this year. Rutgers will get its hands on the ball first. Townsend and Foster are deep for Kevin LaBelle's kick. Townsend behind the wedge. 23 is on a wing. Very dangerous third down player. They love to throw to him. Tia looks that way and throws underneath instead. Incomplete for Dennis Campbell. And Rex Start, he can throw. Fumbles the snap from center. Rutgers says they haven't. No sign from the officials yet.
Well, you mentioned the new starting quarterback, and certainly they took snaps before the game, but a lot of adrenaline, a lot going to want to mess around with if it's tweaked at all.
No. He is their leading receiver, one of the all-time rushers, one of the all-time receivers, one of the all-time touchdown makers. He is just a brilliant player for this club. Clark Harris, who is the leading receiver in terms of yardage, makes that catch and appears. Rice is the single setback here. Here comes the blitz. They great pick timing. It up very well.
Great timing on the blitz by McCullough. He hit that full speed, and because he came and
life. Tonight, he gets a try from 31 to start the game and is wide left.
Wow.
And Cincinnati makes a stand after turning the ball over, and that will fire up the home folks. That's exactly
every angle.
Third and a yard. Moore, strength against strength, and Moore's outside for the first down and gets to midfield. That should be so quick and know every technique in the book. Davila.
Here goes the man-to-man
perfect
cover.
Strike. Davila, throw it on the money to Derek Stewart. He's their speed guy for 25 yards. Now, Davila in the shotgun. Short set, can't find anybody, takes off.
Not bad decision. It's a four-man rush. They dropped seven into coverage. He didn't have anywhere to go with the football.
And the Bearcats will take the lead on undefeated Rutgers. Back this year. Teal in the shotgun with Leonard beside him. Has pressure in his face and throws incomplete. The Cincinnati defense does his job again.
Well, I think what we talked about at the beginning of the show.
Now they go to two wideouts. And dump it underneath again to Jones. And Jones right at that yellow line. All right, Reese, and here come the Cincinnati Bearcats. Glad second and five. Stewart with that speed sets up on the wing. Here comes a blitz. Pass underthrown, but caught by Stewart. Down to the two, first and goal. Jones, the fullback, Gladauer, the tailback. Davila, he can run for it, there's room. Touchdown! LaBelle for the point after. Final poll at 11-0. Teal draw play. Ray Rice.
There you saw that leg strength of Ray Rice. Ray, I mean, he was met in the hole. Senior leadership, and that's when you need the senior leadership, is in a situation like this where you're down on the road.
They seem so well grounded. Teal with plenty of time and throws complete down to the 40-yard line to Kenny Britt. Leonard is the single setback on third and two. Quick throw, little flanker screen out to Townsend, and Townsend has a first down inside the 30.
Great job of blocking by the two wideouts out of
the tailback. They like that little toss better than the handoff, and Rice powers his way to the 25. That always looks like a dangerous play, a tough ticket. Rutgers wins this game, wins next week. It could set up a game for just about everything in the Big East and maybe in the national championship picture, too.
Uh-oh.
Teal, interception. intercepted by D'Angelo Smith, and he's got company down the sideline. D'Angelo Smith will go 83 yards for a touchdown. Adam Hopple was in Teal's face. Teal was trying to make a play, and instead he made a mistake. Shorthand is out in pick six. Defense. Three-man rush. They drop eight in coverage. And Teal throws incomplete right through Townsend's hands and nearly intercepted by Mickens.
Well, another ball.
Kick this time. Stuart Lake fair man. Catch signal.
Did he try to touch the ball?
He may have.
Oh.
And Rutgers has it.
Yeah, just a real error in judgment by Antoine Horton.
Top of the screen this time. Looking the other way, the pass underneath complete, but it's going to be a couple of yards shy of a first down as Kevin McCullough and Anthony Calley is the holder. And Rutgers gets on the scoreboard. They take advantage of the turn.
He's going to get shot down pretty quickly in the next 30 minutes. There's a fumble. So that's the thing you can't have happen here at the end of the half.
This would be unbelievable, and Rutgers has the football. With 12 seconds to go in the half, and you have to ask yourself, how is that possible?
You know, you ask how is it possible, but it happens so many times where teams that are a little bit of a notch below, maybe not expected to win, they play great in the first half and right in. That was just never a clean exchange between the quarterback and fullback. It hit him up around the chest.
Field goal. Blitz coming. Teal toward the end zone.
Great play. Mickens.
Intercepted by Mickens. Holy cow.
You know what? You say that a defensive cornerback has to have short-term memory loss more than any other.
Rice on third and a yard has it.
Ray Rice with the carry right now by Anthony Oates.
Rutgers needs to make this.
That takes a little of that play action out of it.
There's the long pass. And it's intercepted. Mickens is right there again. We've seen him make bad plays. We've seen him make great plays.
But again,
this Cincinnati uniform tonight. Now facing third and six. Straight back to throw this time. No pressure. Throws complete. Dabble nice on shot. Target again. Goodman makes the catch.
But credit the protection again. Again.
Davila playing like he's been the starter all year long. Here comes the pressure. It's a screen. Benton. Breaks a tackle. Benton in the open field. To the five. Two yards. Butler Benton with hitting the tailback. And down goes Davila, coming over the top of the pile, middle linebacker Devron Thompson. He timed it perfectly.
Well, we've
from 20 yards. And if that doesn't lift Rutgers' spirits, nothing will.
It's still panic move. This is just some way to try to change the tempo of the game in their favor.
Pass complete for a first down outside the 40 to the tight end Clark. Third and 11. Rutgers has to get something going on offense. Teal under pressure. Throws underneath. The catch made by Kenny Britt, but well shy of a first down.
Well, did you see that? Have a little chili with your cheese.
Oh, wow.
Holy.
Davila throws on the run as his tight end Brent Celek. Celek looks for a couple of blocks across the 50, 40, 30. Celek's still at his feet at the 10.
Wow. Are you kidding me? 83 yards. Teammates have for Brent Celek.
His little brother is a senior in high school, probably headed to Cincinnati as a tight end. And Celek's feeling a lot better right now. Rutgers is not. The Scarlet Knights are being mugged in Cincinnati. His team's focus. Broken up, guess who? Mickens, and another flag is down. This would be the third interference call. That, watching it live, looked like a great play by Mickens. And Teal has not made these kind of mistakes. Blitz coming. What a block by Leonard. Incomplete, now intercepted. Right in the hands of Williams.
Tequan Underwood didn't even know the ball was coming to him. I think the ball just bounced right off of his hip.
It bounced off of somebody, and Williams ended up being in a right.
For a 44-9 loss last year, guys, so far the winner's manual gave them some great advice.
And what has given them a tremendous spark tonight, Holly, is Nick Davila.
He has gave them a better passing option, a quicker release, a little stronger arm.
Rid of this one out in the flat. Ball comes loose. They got it back.
Wow. Now that's when you know that the bounces are going to lift up by Cincinnati. I mean, they had an embarrassing game last week, and they have come to play tonight.
I agree with you. Davila hit at the sideline. That was close to being an extra 15 from Thompson, but Dav kind of out. John Elway kind of arm. Davila throws as he's hitting a perfect strike to Ali.
How quick that ball gets out of his hands in the face of a blitz. And that peaks and valleys, but this was more about Cincinnati, I think, than it was about Rutgers.
I agree. Gladauer again staying in bounds. He'll be stopped back near the 11-yard line by Courtney Green, the free safety, who was the leading tackler on his quick release. But as you pointed out, a tremendous job by the offensive line. They have really hung in there and given him great.
Mark D'Antonio and his staff and what they're trying to do here with the Bearcats.
Teal going back to work. Clark Harris, the tight end, breaks a tackle. Harris to the 10, 5, to the 1.
Great effort.
D'Angelo Smith at least temporarily saved the touchdown. It's a gain. Except for West Virginia, they held people to very low totals on the ground. And Ray Rice will get into the end zone for a touchdown here at the 534 mark.
But they've been right on that track for what
be the only setback. They move the ball. You have a choice. They move the ball to the near hash mark. And Teal will throw the fade, and it's complete to Underwood for two.
Mike Teal's pass is complete. Tyquan.
Through the frustration of not playing and fight through the frustration of maybe parents or family members or girlfriends saying, hey, you should be starting or you should be playing or whatever, and just keep doing what you have to do. Take a look.
You can. You've won a loss.
Yeah. But you scored 39, too.
Yeah.
In Columbus.
Teal throws. This one's complete. Good catch by Kenny Britt. His seventh grab of the night, and they've got a... Teal goes over the middle, short to Britt. And he's to the 41, about a yard shy of a first down. Picking away of an undefeated season. Teal throws too high, incomplete. And they can start celebrating in Cincinnati. They get the ball back with 2:36 to go win in his tenure here. And this will have a dramatic impact on the Big East standings. Rutgers, Wisconsin. Tonight, it is number 7 Rutgers. They will deny the Scarlet Knights a shot at a national championship. And the crowd here ready to storm the field when this one is over 20 seconds from now.
They need to let Rutgers get to the other end of the field.
They better hurry. Arguably the biggest win in the history of Cincinnati football. Certainly the biggest under Mark D'Antonio, and a very disappointing night for Greg Schiano and the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. But it wasn't a game where a bad call or a bad break decided it. They were outplayed and beaten by a Cincinnati team that was the better team tonight.
They were the better team.